begin with another rocket story. Woo. Another rocket story.
Now imagine a rocket about this high, about this thick, 4 inches in diameter, that could easily fly to 3,000 or more feet in the sky. Have that picture in mind? Well, I'm building one of those, and I even thought of bringing it here tonight to show you. Now, those of you who have heard my other rocket story about the little rocket made from a CO2 cartridge, filled up with gunpowder, will know that I guess I like rockets, and I'm into rockets, and I'm a rocket scientist. But this rocket I'm building is like a hobby rocket. I bought it as part of a kit. YouTube, if you're into rockets, I can tell you where to buy this thing. And you put it together with a lot of epoxy glue. Everything gets glued together. There's the bottom tube where you glue in the fins, where you glue in a motor tube, a retainer ring. Then there's a middle section where you actually put in the parachute for the recovery of this thing. There's a nose cone where, if you're sadistic, you put mice in there. Oh. I'm not going to do that. I don't have mice. You can put that in there, or you can put a GPS system in there so you can find the rocket. This thing takes a big motor like about that size and it can go to 3,000 feet. In fact, it could go so high, if you're not careful, you need a waiver from the FAA to make sure you don't hit an airplane. Now, it sounds kind of like a fun thing to do. Would you want to build a rocket like that?
Yeah, I would.
You would? Yes. It takes a weekend. And I'm doing it in part for fun, but I'm also doing it for a professional reason. It's because I teach rocket propulsion at UIC as part of the Theory of Propulsion course. I teach rocket propulsion to students who are also in a student society called the American Institute of Aeronautics and Astronautics. And many of these students, they're engineering students. It sounds heady, but that's it. They're doing that instead of study. They could be studying art. You're an artist, right? Yep. Mm-hmm. Are you an artist?
Medical doctor.
Oh, medical doctor.
But I mean, I draw when I was younger.
You drew when you were younger, right? Well, it's not a good thing to do if you want a solid income. Mm-hmm. It's a lot better to be an engineer. Mm-hmm. So these students are engineers building rockets as part of this AIAA society. Many of these students, I'd say most of the students, don't take my course on propulsion. But they're building rockets. And I'm thinking, how are they building rockets without taking my course? On the other hand, how am I teaching a course on propulsion without building a rocket? And I realized there was a disconnect between the theory I was teaching and the rockets they were building, and the rockets they were building and the theory I was teaching. Now, maybe you know that in everyday life. There are many people who know the theory of something but can't do it. And there are many people who do things but can't explain why they can do it, right? So here was an opportunity for me to combine the science that I'm teaching and building the rocket. So I went out, bought this kit, went down to the lab with all the people who are building rockets in there, and I started building a rocket. And you know what I discovered? That people who build rockets are geeks. I mean, really geeks. They sit around this room and they talk about, yeah, I shot that rocket off, it went pretty high, but I forgot to glue this. Or I didn't say, I'm thinking, this is all I've got to do is sit around and talk about this rocket and that rocket. But anyway, it was a good experience because now I've got this rocket about this big. I'm going to launch it on May 27th. I'm going to go with the students to a launch site and they're all going. We're going to go and get certified, and I don't know where this is going to lead, because after you shoot one rocket, you want to shoot off another one. And the next thing, I mean, I could be going bigger and bigger and maybe to the moon or something. I don't know. But what I learned from this, and maybe it's something that we all need reminding, or you might need reminding, Tim, is that there's a disconnect between the theory and the practice. And it's important, especially if you're a teacher, to make sure you get out and do what you're teaching. In fact, isn't there a saying, people who can't do, teach?
Yes.
Right? Can't teach, audit.
Yeah. What is that?
People who can't teach, audit.
So what I'm doing is, I'm teaching it, I'm building the rocket, I'm bringing the two together, and it's been a very good experience. So I recommend it to you. If this story inspires you, talk to me afterwards. I can tell you where to buy a rocket. And you and your husband on a Sunday during the summer, as one of the highlights of your summer, to build a rocket that goes to the moon. Mr. Toastmasters.
Build rockets when I was a kid. I loved them. Very good, rockets. So next up we have the